Chude, you are going somewhere that I'm not, tough. Okay. Well, he is dealing with issues, and it's been going on for a couple of years. It's known as dementia with Lewy body, and it's a degenerative disease that affects the brain, and it's almost like a kind of Parkinson's, but that just it's the brain that it affects, so you don't see the shaking and things like that, you know, but it just affects the person. Phew, first time I've said that publicly. Yes.
I mean, I'm honored. I feel like it's sacred. Yeah. I knew that there was a
Yeah. I mean, a time would have to come when, you know, people, you know, it had to be, it would have to be known. But the thing is that it's hard, you know, it's hard on him. It's hard on him because he doesn't understand what's going on. And it's equally as hard on other members of the family as well. So, we've gone through it over the last couple of years, and we thank God.
Yeah.
We thank God. Yeah. Yes.
I mean, I don't want. Yes. I mean, I'm again, I want to talk about it on you, you know, because you said it's hard on you. And
it's hard on the family.
Yes, and on the family. Yeah, because you guys have done so much together.
Exactly, we have.
You know, you've lived, and there's a the relationship between you two, I mean, people have been fascinated about it for years.
I know, magazine interviews.
So anybody watching that can sense that I know there's, I heard that there's no perfect marriage. There's a tenderness and a closeness that's between you guys.
Mm.
Then you work together, you've done interesting things together.
Mm-hmm.
You must miss that.
Oh, yes, I do. I mean, we've gone through some times, you know, there've been some situations recently, and I'm like, oh, I just wish, you know, I had, you know, the old you here, because I knew that, you know, I wouldn't have to battle this on my own.
Yeah.
but even then, there are moments, and you know, which, you know, very close friends, when they ask after him, and they say, I say, well, we are grateful for the moments of clarity.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
We're grateful for
the
those
moments
of
clarity. Yeah. You lost your sister a few years ago.
Mm-hmm. 2019.
Yes. Yeah. And you know, I guess maybe people who know the history, but then she, you know, built her own, one of the Nigeria's most respected art curators, etc. And you had your own career, so sometimes in the public space people didn't make the linkage, I think, younger people at least. But this was your sister, you know, and this was, and so people were in the art community were mourning her, but this was also very personal for you. What was that like? And you know, with loss, this is, as far as I know, in terms of people who are closer, not parents. So you lost your daughter, I think, in 1996. So this is, so I want to ask about that, but first, with your sister, how did that hit you?
Horribly. Horribly.
I would imagine.
Horribly, because when we discovered she had cancer, I mean, she called me aside. I went to, you know, she lived with my mom, you know, so I, she called me aside and said, look, Joker, this is what I found. And I said, okay, we've got to find out what it is, you know. And then we, you know, did the test. The tests were done, and then discovered she had cancer. And so we traveled together for her first, you know, lumpectomy that she did. And I think what made it really hard was the fact that at the same time, another person I loved very much was ill.
Mm-hmm.
And so I couldn't look after her. So she was abroad with one of her, God bless her, you know. And she was with one of our sisters, you know, very close family friends, so we're like sisters. So she, you know, this sister had to look after her, and I couldn't. Mm-hmm. So the fact that, but I, you know, there was, one of the people who went to see her, you know, while she was in London, said something to me after she died. She said, you know, he went to see her, and she said, oh, don't worry, my sister is going to come and take me home. She will definitely come and take me home, you know. And that really, really gave me comfort, because she knew I was with her. And unfortunately, I actually couldn't come because we were performing in the US at the time. But this sister that I talked about in England brought her back home. And so we're able to spend the last couple of weeks, it was, you know, together. So that kind of gave comfort. It was hard because we're only like 8 months apart.
Yeah.
And she was just such an intellectual, her intellectual rigor is practically second to none, especially when it comes to art,
yeah.
You know? And we, you know, we shared, I think that's what I miss, because there are discussions that I have with her that I can't have with anybody else. Yes. So, but when she died, and the outpouring from different parts of the world of, you know, of the work that she had done, even we in the family, we didn't know. We just used to think that she was the one that had taken over my mother's kind of traveling. You know, my mother used to travel a lot, and so she was an Ajala travel like mom. You know, so when you were just getting all these write-ups about her and the outpouring. The outpouring of emotion, you just knew that she lived a life of impact, which was what she wanted.
Yes.
Yeah.